is Brett Kern, the punter, different from Brett Kern, the punter back in the Denver days?
Well, I mean, besides being a lot older and a lot more games under my belt, you know, I think in Denver, you know, really you're just trying to make a team. Feel like you're trying to stay afloat, you know, those first couple of years that you're in the league. And, you know, right now it's a totally different mindset of, you know, I feel a lot more relaxed out there. I've obviously played in a lot of stadiums, have a lot of punts under my belt, and just have a different outlook on just punting in general. You know, I just want to go out there and do the best that I can on each punt. You know, we've talked about it before. I don't get lost in the statistics, you know, that can happen every game. And really just have fun and enjoy it. You know, I'm not going to be able to play football forever, and just enjoy each moment that's before me.
Is there a fraternity among NFL punters and kickers?
There is, yeah. You know, you got a lot of guys, text messages, you know, whether it's through social media or whether you just, you know, texting on your phone. A lot of times you kind of throw around, you know, I'll watch guys like Sam Cook in Baltimore, Johnny Hecker, Morstead, and, you know, those guys are very innovative. You know, Johnny's come up with some really cool punts over the years. So whether it's texting him, trying to pick his brain, what he's doing, you know, Sam in Baltimore was one of the first guys to come up with that boomerang type punt, just picking his brain about it.
When you down a punt at the 1 yard line in the AFC playoffs at New England, and the game ends, you win the ball game, you come back and you look at your phone, have you gotten a bunch of texts from other NFL punters saying, dude, beautiful?
Yeah, I did. That was that's probably the most text messages I've had in a really, really long time after that game. And honestly, you know, I don't think it really hit me just kind of the magnitude of that punt until, you know, whenever it was in quarantine and the local TV shows were, or the local TV station was showing the replay of the game. And that was really the first time that I got to see it happen. And, you know, with Tony Romo and Jim Nantz calling it, just the TV copy.
Belichick started as a special teams coach. He has all that stuff.
Now he's come all the way back up to near the midfield mark.
They're coming after him with everybody.
They blocked 4 punts this season. Most in the league. And Kern gets a line drive punt away that's bounding to a halt at the 1. Perfection.
Dire straits indeed, Jim. This one just got, that's Coach Belichick said he's the best right now, and Kern did it.
That's really the first time that it sunk in, because, you know, after the New England game, you knew that we were on to Baltimore. So you kind of already, you know, in the locker room after the game, you enjoyed the moment, but really on the bus ride to the airport, you're already starting to think about Baltimore. I was already looking at the weather forecast for the next week, and you kind of forget about what kind of happened in that game. And so, you know, we were all watching, sitting down as a family, watching the replay of the game, and to be able to see that punt was, that was pretty crazy.
A great punter in the NFL is a weapon, right?
Yeah.
I mean, that's what you want to be. You want to be a weapon to affect change in how your defense and your offense are affected by how you kick the ball.
Yeah, I mean, you know, you want to be considered a weapon. You want to be able to go out there, if you're backed up and you need a big punt, you know, you got to be able to go out there and deliver it. If you're playing against a great returner, you know, how often can you get them to the sidelines or even kick it out of bounds? You know, when I go back at the end of the season and I chart all my kicks and look at different situations, you know, I can go back and look at, hey, you know, I remember when I had this punt and it went out at the 5, you know, the next plays that transpired. I look at the Cleveland game, you know, last year, having that punt, I think it was like a 70-yarder, and the returner let it go, and Chris Milton did a great job of getting down there. We downed it on the 3, and then I think 2 plays later, Cameron Wake had a sack for a safety, and just kind of how that changed the momentum. And, you know, a lot of people might not remember that play, but, you know, I know that was a big momentum changer in that game.
All-Pro Brett Kern, thanks for being our Nissan Insider this week.
Thanks, Mike.